everyone, my name is Melody. Thank you for clicking on this video. So it is officially the NHL offseason. I don't know about you guys, but I've been bracing myself. By the way, congratulations to the Tampa Bay Lightning on their back-to-back weird Stanley Cup championships. Hopefully this is the end of all the weirdness. We can finally go back to normal next year. So back at it again with another trade reactions video. This time, I asked you guys to send me in some Sam Reinhart trade offers. Probably in the last time I'm ever going to wear this jersey, so that's fun. So I wanted you guys to send me in some Sam Reinhart trade offers because honestly, I'm just very curious to know how he's perceived around the NHL. So Sam Reinhart is a restricted free agent this year, 1 year away from unrestricted free agency. And like his best buddy Jack Eichel, he would not commit to a future with the Buffalo Sabres in his end of season little presser. So being 1 year away from unrestricted free agency and with, you know, him clearly saying that he's not really interested in being a part of another rebuild. I'm sure the Sabres are taking a lot of calls on him, which, you know, sucks. God, like, I just think back to those 2 years, like, when we had an AHL team in 2014 and 2015 when we were intentionally tanking. And just to think that, you know, we threw those 2 seasons away, that those teams weren't even watchable. And we did it all just to get at the top of the draft. And now the 2 players we took second overall in back-to-back years don't even want to be here 6 years later. That's gotta say, I am totally at a loss when, I've been thinking a lot about Sam Reinhart's trade value. I don't know. I have no idea what he could fetch. So that's why I wanted to ask you guys. I wanted to see what you guys thought. So unlike Jack, who had the worst season of his career, Sam Reinhart is coming off arguably the best season of his career. He had 25 goals in 54 games this year, which would equate to about a 38 goal pace in an 82 game season, which would have by far been his career high. Only 15 assists, which is a little bit low for him, but when you factor in the fact that, like, you know, he played half the season with Ralph, I don't believe in offense, Kruger. And the fact that Jack Eichel only played 21 games this season, I mean, it's pretty impressive. Sam Reinhart really didn't have anybody to pass to. So, I mean, all in all, like, all things considered, I think Sam had a great year. You know, he's always been a guy that's kind of been living in Jack Eichel's shadow, which is probably why he's never gotten a long-term deal, and he just kept getting bridge deal after bridge deal, which is kind of why we're in this situation. So I'm curious, I wanted to know, so I asked you guys to send me in some trade offers. And from a quick look at this, it looks like a lot of you didn't read the whole post. It looks like you guys stopped reading after the first sentence. Because I said, I know you guys like to be funny and offer food, beer, and other funny things, but I'm way more curious about his actual value, so just stick to actual trade offers. Come on, guys. Isn't that what they teach you in school? Read the entire question before giving your answer? It's okay, I never listened in school. Again, if you ever want to be a part of these videos in the future, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification so you get notified when I make these community posts. And as always, feel free to leave your own comment below. Keep the discussion going, what you think Sam Reinhart's trade value is. So I don't think I'm going to be giving a lot of, like, commentary, like, whether or not I think a trade is fair, just because, I don't know, I just don't really know. So I think I'm just kind of more so going to react to what you guys have to say, and yeah, here we go, let's get into it. To Vegas, Sam Reinhart. To Buffalo, Alex Tuck in a second. I'd be interested to see what direction they go for Sam. Like, so for example, I think with Jack, their main objective is to kind of get, like, picks and prospects. I'm wondering if for Sam, they more so choose, like, maybe, like, an actual NHL player route. I just think it would make more sense because, like, I mean, eventually, like, someone has to play for you, right? You have to get some kind of actual NHL talent. You can't just solely bank on prospects, I guess. Because, you know, the Sabres, they don't always work out. I'd be very interested to see if they go that direction. I've always kind of been more in favor of that, like, trade Jack Eichel for the future, trade Sam Reinhart for maybe someone who can help a little bit more now. But yeah, I don't know. I've always really liked Alex Tuck, though. To Buffalo, the 11th overall pick, Strome, and a C-level prospect. To Chicago, Sam Reinhart. If they can get, like, a first of roster player and a prospect, I think that's probably pretty good return for him. I just always think about Dylan Strome. Like I said, I think back a lot about, like, how awful, like, those tank seasons were, how stressful that second one was when we really wanted McDavid or Eichel. And I just think, like, near the end of the season, the Sabres, like, actually were playing well, and they they look like they might actually blow the, you know, the guarantee at one or the other. So I just think about, like, how awful it would have been if the Sabres would have, like, ended up picking third and getting Strome. So then you see McDavid, Eichel, and then Strome, and then Marner went after, and then, you know, there were a ton of other really good players in that first round. Ugh, man. I would imagine, though, like, if the Sabres could get, like, a top 15 pick for Sam Reinhart, that's probably what they would want to do. That's interesting. Sam Reinhart to Philadelphia for Nolan Patrick, Travis Sanheim, a 2021 third, and a conditional 2022 second. Have to make it past the first round of the playoffs. I don't know about, like, in a Sam Reinhart deal, but I'd be interested to see if the Sabres kind of take some chances on guys that maybe they think could have bounce back years. Like, you look at Nolan Patrick, and I don't know, he was so hyped coming out of the draft. Obviously, he had his migraine thing, and I don't know. I don't think for Sam they would want to kind of take risks on that. Like, I feel like they would want more of a guarantee. Like, I think with Nolan Patrick, like, I would imagine eventually he's going to kind of figure it out. But then, like, Travis Sanheim, too, I'm pretty sure, didn't he have a kind of a down year, too? So, I don't know. Like, I think that trade would be a little bit too risky for the Sabres. I think, you know, when trading Jack and Sam, they kind of want a little less risk involved, I would imagine. I don't know. To the Rangers, Reinhart in a fourth. To Buffalo, Hedel, Robertson, and a second. Not gonna lie, I feel like a lot of the Jack Eichel trade offers I've seen have had similar, like, foundation. I think out of, like, any team, I feel like I'm most interested to see what the Rangers do this offseason. I just think they have such a good foundation, and they have so many pieces that, like, they could move. I don't know. I feel like they're set up really well, and I'm very interested to see what they do. To the Flyers, Sam Reinhart and Rasmus Ristolainen. To the Sabres, Nolan Patrick, Bobby Brink, and a second. There's been talk about that, too, I think, because Elliot Friedman and Darren Dreger come on the Sabres radio every single week, and I had heard some talk about that. Like, if the Sabres are trading Jack Eichel, would they be willing to add in Sam Reinhart? Would they be willing to add in Rasmus Ristolainen and make it, like, a massive blockbuster crazy trade? I wouldn't even be against, like, the idea of packaging both Sam and Rasmus to kind of, like, really boost that value. I know that's a lot of salary, because I know Rasmus makes over $5 million. Sam is due a new contract. But I'd be totally for that, because, like, I don't know how much Rasmus would actually fetch in a trade by himself. Maybe if you add him along with Sam, maybe that makes it a little bit more interesting. I don't know. Again, I'm not really into the idea of taking risks, I guess, and hoping for bounce backs, but I'm interested in to see if they package multiple players out of the three, the Jack, Sam, and Rasmus, that they're most likely going to trade this offseason. But I just think that makes it more fun. To Toronto, Sam Reinhart. To Buffalo, Alex Kerfoot, and 2 third-round picks. If I don't like second-round picks, I really don't like third-round picks. I'm trying to think if, like, there's ever been a player that the Sabres drafted in the third round, at least in recent memory or in my lifetime, that have actually turned out. And I can't really think of any off the top of my head. Hold on, let me look. No. 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 So it looks like really the only one that's, like, actually an NHL player is Brayden McNabb, who was drafted in 2009. Oh, and then Andre Sequeira, he was a player. He played. He was drafted in 2004. Other than that, no. The Sabres don't really get any kind of value at all out of the third round. So essentially that would be, like, Sam Reinhart for Alex Kerfoot. Also, like, the idea of Sam Reinhart in a Maple Leafs jersey hurts my soul, so. To the Flames, Reinhart and Eichel. To the Sabres, Monahan, Goudreau, Zari, Ruzicka. 2 firsts, a second, and a third. Whoa! I love those ones. Those are my favorite kind of trades to react to. Just the crazy, like, let's just go nuts and let's just see what happens. That's a lot coming from the Flames, though. So Zari was their first-round pick last year, right? So that's, like, essentially 3 first-round picks there. I don't know who Ruzicka is. And then Monahan and Goudreau. That's crazy. I feel like the Sabres and the Flames are both kind of in, like, maybe a bit of a similar situation where maybe they're wondering if their core can get the job done. Because you always hear, like, all these Flames, like, all the bigger names on the Flames being involved in trade discussions. So, I will say, though, like, in terms of Sam Reinhart, there have been, like, so many rumors that he just wants to be in, like, Western Canada, like, be shipped out west to Canada. So, like, the Flames would make a lot of sense because his dad, Paul, played for the Flames, or Vancouver because he grew up, he's from Vancouver. I don't know about Jack, but I could definitely see a situation where Sam Reinhart goes to the Flames for sure. To Columbus, Sam Reinhart. To Buffalo, Corpusello, Liam Foti, and the 24th overall pick in this year's draft. Yeah, not 2020. I feel like from everything that, like, the insiders are saying, like, I feel like Columbus has been the team that's come up the most when talking about Sam Reinhart. You hear their name all the time. And I think it got Sabres fans a little nervous because one of the insiders said that, like, the Sabres were interested in, like, Reinhart for one of their goalies, and I think they were saying, like, straight up, which I would not ever be a fan of. I'm not huge. Like, you could just get goalies. Like, I wouldn't trade a top 6 center for a goalie in a rebuilding, when your team's rebuilding, you know what I mean? Like, that doesn't make any sense. Like, I know that the Sabres probably want a goalie. I mean, they have one in Ullmark, but, you know, he probably will walk in free agency. But, I mean, if you're trading away Jack, you're trading away Sam, you're trading away Risto, you're probably going into a rebuild mode. So what, I just don't really see what good a goalie does. Like, you're just hanging them out to dry because you're going to suck for a couple more years. You know what I mean? The Sabres have a couple good goalies in their system. So, I mean, if they could just find somebody for cheap just to, you know, fill the gap for a couple years until those guys are ready to come up, I think that's probably more of the direction that they go. But I like that, you know, it's not straight up Reinhart for a goalie. I like that you added in a couple more things. To the Kings, Samson Reinhart. To the Sabres, the 8th overall pick, and Rasmus Kupari. I feel like the Sabres really like this draft for some reason, because there's been so much talk about how that they want to really load up on picks this year. They want to get these trades done before the draft so they can have picks this year. I don't even really think that's bad value for Sam, though. I mean, like, a top 8 pick and a prospect. Go back to the Sabres picking 8th overall, because that's all they do. That's all they've done over the past, like, 8 years. In Montreal, Sam Reinhart to Buffalo. Kotkaniemi, Byron, a 2021 first, a 2022 fourth, and Gianni Fairbrother. It cannot be a Melody Reacts to Trade Offers video without Paul Byron's name coming up, right? He always comes up. I honestly don't really feel one way or the other about Jesperi Kotkaniemi. Like, I don't know. I know he was scratched in the final, and I know he was scratched earlier in the playoffs, too. But I don't know. I don't really feel one way or the other. That's just a lot. That's, like, a lot of things for Sam. To Colorado, Sam Reinhart. To Buffalo, a 2021 first, 2022 first, Martin Kaut, and JT Compher. Ah, JT Compher. So that's actually pretty interesting. Like, obviously, you know, the two first-round picks would be nowhere near some of the other first-round picks that have been offered, like nowhere near Columbus, nowhere near LA. So those would be at the end of the first round. But that's interesting value for him, honestly. I've always loved JT Compher. Like, in the O'Reilly trade, when we acquired Ryan O'Reilly, I was bummed that we gave Compher up. And then Martin Kaut, like, eh. Oh, look at that. He scored his first NHL goal against the Sabres. But yeah, no, that's interesting. To Calgary, Sam Reinhart, because his dad played here, and I'm sure he'd love it. Yeah. To Buffalo, Sean Monahan, Dylan Dubé, and a 2021 first, which is the 12th overall, and a 2022 second. I mean, I would imagine the Sabres would probably be pretty happy with that. You get Monahan, which is basically probably a replacement for Sam. Dubé, roster player, and then the 12th overall pick and a second, even though I don't like seconds. Yeah, I mean, I think I'd be more than happy with that for Sam. Again, from Calgary, to Calgary, Sam Reinhart, and to Buffalo, Sean Monahan, Oliver Shillington, and a 2022 second, 2022 third. And that is from my pal Paul, who's I Don't Give a Kachuk, the YouTube channel. If you don't follow him, totally go check him out. Yeah, again, like, I could totally see, like, a Flames move like that. I know Paul probably wouldn't like it, but I like the idea of the Sabres trading Reinhart for, and, you know, plus something else for Kachuk, but I don't think Paul would like that. But I could totally see him going to the Flames for sure. Reinhart goes back to his hometown of Vancouver in exchange for Brock Besser, Louis Erickson, and a third. I've been getting some, like, mixed reviews on Brock Besser. Like, I've had people who have, like, offered him in Sam Reinhart trades, and I've had people who are like, don't even think about Brock Besser! Which I guess makes sense either way, because, like, I feel like they're comparable. The addition of Louis Erickson, though, is interesting, and I feel like I'm honestly hoping that if the Sabres are truly all in on this idea of a rebuild, they do something like that, where they take on bad contracts. I'm pretty sure Louis Erickson, he only has, like, 1 year left on his contract anyway. Like, if that helps, like, if the Sabres could get more value in a Sam Reinhart trade by taking back a bad contract, or, you know, in anything, if they could get value for taking on, you know, Tampa's obviously going to be way over the cap. There's going to be a ton of teams with the flat cap that are going to be in some trouble. Like, the Sabres have a ton of cap room this year. I would totally love to see them, you know, make moves like that to take on cap. If we're going to be suffering anyway with another rebuild, you might as well get more value for it, I guess. So that's interesting. I'm sure Canucks fans would love that Louis Erickson contract gone. Yeah, again, okay, so to Buffalo, the 9th overall pick in Louis Erickson. To Vancouver, Sam Reinhart. I think taking on Erickson's salary would make Vancouver more willing to part with the 9th overall pick. Erickson only has 1 year left on his contract, so his contract won't be a big problem down the line. See, so that's kind of where I feel like this is, like, all over the place. Like, you have one person saying, like, yeah, hey, Brock Besser and Louis Erickson. And another one saying the 9th overall pick and Louis Erickson. You know, Brock Besser's value and the 9th overall pick's value are, I think, two totally different things. So that's why I was very interested in just to see the different perspectives. And, like, I feel like his value, his perception around the league is, like, it could really honestly just be all over the place, so that's why I find it interesting. To the Minnesota Wild, Sam Reinhart. To the Buffalo Sabres, Matt Dumba, and a second or a late first. This deal makes a ton of sense for both teams. The Wild get a top center for Kaprizov and get away from the expansion draft crunch, and Buffalo gets a great defensive partner for Dahlin and another 2021 draft pick. Yeah, that's interesting, too. I've always really liked Matt Dumba. And I would love to see Sam Reinhart on a line with Kaprizov or something. Because, like, the thing was, like, Sam has just never played center in Buffalo. Like, he played center, honestly, really for the first time. He had a couple, like, little minor stints at center throughout his career, but he really only started playing center once Granato kind of took over, and he was, like, really good at center. So Sam Reinhart feeding him would probably be pretty sick. Dumba's interesting, though. Like, I feel like the Sabres kind of need to still focus on forwards a little bit. Like, obviously, unless they get, like, all forwards in, like, a Jack Eichel trade or something like that. But I still think they're kind of a little it's hard to say heavy on anything because they're heavy on literally nothing, but they did kind of like, they've drafted a ton of defensemen. They're going to get the first overall pick. Owen Power is a defenseman. So I still think they need to build their forward group a little bit more, but yeah, I mean, I've always liked Matt Dumba. To Winnipeg, Sam Reinhart, a 2021 second, a 2021 seventh, and our 2022 third. To Buffalo, Kyle Connor, and a 2021 fourth. I love all like the extra picks moving around there. That'd be another interesting one too, though. Like, I don't know about all those extra picks, but essentially Reinhart for Connor being a one for one. I feel like I would be way more interested in something like that, like a one for one instead of picks and prospects. Like, that would just, I feel like it would make it way more fun. Reinhart for Matthew Tkachuk. There's the one I wanted. Buffalo fans would love Tkachuk. Yeah, I know there have been rumors about Calgary potentially trading Matthew Tkachuk, and I love this point that like Buffalo fans would love Tkachuk, because I, like, if you look back at like some of the fan favorites in Sabres history, like Pat Coletta comes to mind. Like, Sabres fans just love like these gritty, irritating, agitating kind of guys, and I feel like Buffalo fans really in any sport kind of value work ethic more over skill. At least I do. But like Matthew Tkachuk, he's just such a pest, and I feel like Sabres fans would absolutely love him. I would imagine that the Sabres would definitely have to add to Reinhart. I know we have 2 seconds this year. There was one trade I saw, and I forget who said it, but it was essentially like Sam Reinhart and Victor Olofsson for Matthew Tkachuk, and I thought that was interesting. That's what I want. That's what I'm after. I know Calgary fans would probably counter, like, they're like, if we're trading Tkachuk, we better be getting Eichel, you know, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Here's an interesting one. Tobias Bjornfoot, Akil Thomas, the 8th overall pick, and a 2nd round pick for the 1st overall pick. LA needs Owen Power. So, like, is Sam Reinhart not even included in that? Like, all of those things just to move back 7 spots? Like, hell yeah. I don't know if you meant to include Sam Reinhart in that too, but like, if you're giving me Bjornfoot, Thomas, and a 2nd just to move back 7 spots, like, I'm not even 100% sold on Owen Power. Like, I'm not like super crazy excited about him. So if you're giving me all that stuff, you can absolutely, we'll do that right now. To Buffalo, Nils Höglander, 2021 first, and Brogan Rafferty. To Vancouver, Sam Reinhart. I really only like Höglander in this deal. I can really only see them getting a mid-high prospect and maybe a pick out of Reinhart. Whether the pick is top 15 or top 10, Sam Reinhart is going to come out the better part of this trade. Yeah. Well, I mean, that's the thing too. Like, when you're doing this, when you're rebuilding like this, especially if you're trading for futures, chances are you're probably losing the trade. Like, I mean, if you look at the O'Reilly trade, that was just the worst. They always usually say, like, if you get the best player in the deal, you win the deal. I mean, what? Vancouver picks 9th? So, I mean, I'm fine with that. Ooh, interesting. So, to LA, Sam Reinhart and the 1st overall pick. To Buffalo, Alex Turcotte, Arthur Kaliev, and the 8th overall pick. That's, That makes you think a little bit, doesn't it? I feel like the Sabres are pretty adamant about not trading the 1st overall pick. But I like these ones that make you think. So, because you feel like you hear, like, Turcotte, Kaliev, 8th overall pick. You hear a lot of that in, like, the Jack Eichel offers that you get from LA, because apparently they're never going to be able to pry Byfield out of there. Adding in the 1st makes it interesting. Oh, I don't know about that. That's cool. I feel like it'd be, like, better if the Sabres were also able to get, like, another top 5 pick for Eichel. And then it'd probably be a little bit easier to swallow getting rid of the 1st overall pick. But, It's interesting, though. To the Rangers, Samson Reinhart. To Buffalo, Ryan Strome, Matthew Robertson, and the 15th overall pick. See, it's just so funny because, like, so many of these, like, Rangers fans trade offers, you hear a lot of these same players in the Jack Eichel trades. I know that the Sabres really don't want to trade Jack in the Eastern Conference, which, good. I'm wondering if they're more willing to trade Sam in the Eastern Conference. Like, I wonder if they really don't care one way or the other where Sam goes, as long as they get the best value for him. Probably still good value for Sam too, though, because you get basically a replacement for him in Strome, and you get a D prospect in Robertson and the 15th overall pick. I'm sure they'd be happy with that. Strome's pretty cheap too. Like, he's a year away from UFA, but 4.5, like, Sam Reinhart's gonna cost way more than that. Kyler Yamamoto, Tyler Benson, and a 3rd rounder for Reinhart. Yamamoto struggled offensively last year, but I think he has a good chance to be a hardworking top 6 forward, similar to Brendan Gallagher. Benson is kind of an iffy prospect, but he's put up good AHL numbers and could become a good middle 6 player or better if he improves his skating a bit. Yeah, again, same thing with, like, the Flyers trade offers. Like, I'm not sure that the Sabres really want to, in a Reinhart trade, want to bet on bounce backs. I mean, I guess they could if they're really thinking that there's a good chance of a bounce back. I feel like they'd either want their own picks or a little bit more of a guarantee. But yeah, that's interesting. A 1st, a 2nd, and a middle of the road prospect. Yeah, that's probably about his value. I don't know. Like, if you think about it, like, if he gets offer sheeted, and I don't know the exact, like, compensation numbers off the top of my head, but, like, if he gets offer sheeted, probably around his number that he would get offer sheeted, and I would imagine he won't. But if he does, I think he'd be around, like, that first, second, third number for compensation. So, I mean, yeah, it's probably about his value, I'd imagine. Bruins fan, DeBrusque and a 2022 second-round pick. I know how much you love second-rounders. You know I don't. Jake DeBrusque may be a bit streaky and had a bad 2021, but honestly, he's not that bad of a winger. Yeah, I mean, again, same thing. Like I don't love the idea of trading Sam for the hope of a bounce-back year, but also I hate second-round picks. I don't even hate second-round picks. I just hate the way the Sabres use their second-round picks. To Vancouver, Reinhart. To Buffalo, Erickson. 2021 first, 9th overall, and 2023 first. Yeah, again, with Vancouver and wanting to get rid of Erickson. It's so crazy to think about, like, that 2016, like, free agency. Like, the whole offseason was just nuts in general, but, like, you think about how awful that, you know, free agent class was. Like, you know, you have Louis Erickson, who signed a bad contract. You have Kyle Poso, who with the Sabres, who signed an awful contract that we still have 2 years left of. And I know that there was talk about, like, how the Sabres are trying to get Seattle to take him. Who else? Like, Lucic signed a bad contract. Andrew Ladd. Oh, my God. Like, it's crazy how awful that was for a lot of teams. Lucky for the Canucks, they only signed Erickson to a 6-year deal. We were stuck with Kyle Poso, gave him a 7-year deal. Buffalo should try to do a similar trade to the Carolina-Calgary with Lindholm and Hanifin going to Calgary in exchange for Hamilton, Ferland, and Fox. Ristolainen and Reinhart package, essentially. Yeah, I like that a lot. I like this idea of, like, that was such a cool trade. Like, I love trades like that where it's actual, like, names for names going back and forth. Like, it's not just, like, a player for picks and prospects. Like, it's actual... Like, there's just a lot going on back and forth. So, again, yeah, I would have no issue if Reinhart and Ristolainen were packaged, if that means, you know, it could be more of a hockey trade like the Calgary-Carolina trade. Like, I just think it would make sense because you still need to bring in roster players, right? You need to bring in guys, so guys like Dylan Cousins and Casey Mittelstadt and Tage Thompson, like, all these younger guys aren't carrying the load of, like, an awful rebuilding team. Like, you still want to be somewhat competitive. You still want these guys to, you know, not lose their love of the game of hockey. But I'd be way more interested, I feel like, in that. Like, package the two of them, maybe. Get some roster players and then use the Jack Eichel trade for picks and prospects. But, yeah, very good point. Very good point to bring up the Lindholm, Hanifin, Hamilton, Fox trade. Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if the haul they got for Reinhart isn't comparable or maybe higher potential than what they get for Eichel just based on what the injury concerns could be. Yeah, so that's kind of what I think I might be learning from this little experiment, is that, like, maybe their value isn't as far apart, you know what I mean? Because Reinhart's coming off of the best year of his career, arguably, and Jack Eichel's coming off of the obvious worst year of his career. So it's good, at least they're both not coming off of horrible years and demanding trades. Again, like, maybe, like, it's a different kind of trade. Like, maybe Jack gets the prospects, maybe Sam gets a roster player. But yeah, I think it's crazy to think about. Like, if you would have asked me last year, like, if I would have thought that Jack Eichel and Sam Reinhart's trade value would be comparable, similar, I would have been like, no way, that's crazy. But yeah, I mean, you might be right. Sam Reinhart to Vegas for Cody Glass, a 2021 third, 2022 conditional pick, third round, but goes to a second round pick if Vegas makes it to the Final Four in 2022. You know they will. Cody Glass would help the loss of center for Buffalo while stock picks for the future. While Vegas gets a center that helps with their win now mentality, Glass gets a fresh start on team that would be able to give him more ice time. It also helps that teams are in different divisions. Side note, I hope in the near future you get to cheer on a Buffalo team worthy of you as a fan. Cheers. Well, I appreciate that, Connor. I mean, again, like, that, like, third-round picks and second-round picks just are essentially nothing for the Sabres. Like, they don't draft well, they don't develop their prospects well. So that would essentially be Reinhart for Cody Glass, which I'm sure Cody Glass is going to be fine, but I don't know. Ooh, another crazy one. So to Minnesota, Sam Reinhart, Jack Eichel, and the first overall pick. To Buffalo, both first-round picks this year, a future first, Marco Rossi, Matt Dumba, Hunter Jones, and Ryan O'Rourke. Oh, man. Could you imagine just, like, how absolutely bonkers Buffalo, New York would go if they traded Sam Reinhart and Jack Eichel and the first overall pick in the exact same deal? I feel like that would be one hell of a deal for Minnesota. Like, they get, like, three firsts. And Marco Rossi was a first last year. Matt Dumba is a good player. I honestly don't know who Hunter Jones and Ryan O'Rourke are. Again, with the crazy deals. I love it. But that'd be a lot of salary that Minnesota would have to take on. Because Jack makes 10. Samson, I would imagine he'd probably be in, like, the $7 million range. It's, like, 17 right there. Leafs, Timothy Liljegren, Alex Kerfoot, 2023 first and a second, and a 2022 first. For Reinhart and the first overall pick. Ah, Leafs. Get out of here. The Leafs just, like, not interested in, like, ever having first-round picks, by the way. I feel like I always see them trading away their first-round picks. I mean, they're, like, lower first-round picks anyway, but I just don't like the idea of Sam Reinhart in a Leafs jersey. It's gross. Huge mistake if they trade him. I agree, but what can he even do anymore? No one wants to be here. Depending on Jack's injury, prognosis, and rehab, Sam could pull more than Jack in a trade. Eichel rumors are 4 first-round pick equivalents. I think winds up at like 2 or 3, and Sam lands at or above that, yeah. Don't want a goalie involved in either deal. Can find a reasonable bridge to UPL through other means, including re-signing Ullmark and getting a backup as a UFA. Absolutely. Sam is not the guy that brings Byfield or someone like that in. Most likely a winger, high prospect, and a first. Yeah, I totally, everything you said, that was, yeah, very, very well said. Definitely agree with the goalie part. I know there's been talk about the Sabres trying to get a goalie, but especially in a flat cap era, there's going to be a lot of goalies available. You can get goalies cheap, so that's a good point. But if, honestly, he gets, like, a roster player, a prospect at a first, like, I mean, you gotta take it if the guy doesn't want to be here. Ideally, you don't want to trade him, but if he doesn't want to be here and he can bring that in, I mean, I guess that's what you gotta do. To Vegas, Sam Reinhart in the 2022 third. To Buffalo, Cody Glass, Riley Smith, a 2021 first, and a 2022 first. See, yeah, so that's what I'm saying. That's where the value differs. The one person said Cody Glass and a couple third-round picks, and this one's saying Cody Glass, Riley Smith, and 2 first-round picks. So that's what I love about these, is just to see the different perspectives and see, you know, how different people value certain players. I just think that's interesting. I like that one better. Flames get Reinhart and Tobias Reeder for Monahan, Peltier, and this year's first and next year's first. Wow. You gotta take Reinhart out of that. Tobias Reeder is worth Monahan, Peltier, and 2 first-round picks alone. It's funny, I was told I was really gonna like Tobias Reeder, and then I just, like, didn't. I think he's a UFA anyway, so if you want him, you can just have him. So if you take Reeder out of the question, it's essentially Reinhart for Monahan, Peltier, and 2 firsts. Sounds good to me. Let me first state, I think Reinhart is on equal value to Horvat and Deneau. Depending on what he wants to sign for with another team will be the biggest issue, yeah. If another team can lock him up for the 5.5 range for 8 years, I think you get a good return. I can see Reinhart in a second to get Tkachuk if the Flames are truly doing a revamp. I would love that. Imagine first line of Tkachuk and Cousins in a few years. Yeah, I mean, that'd be okay with me. I definitely don't think Samson re-signs in the 5.5 range. I think he's more in, like, the 7, 7.5 range. But I think it's very interesting too, because that is something that other teams might have to worry about, is that, you know, you trade for him, he is a year away from unrestricted free agency. So what are you going to give up? Like, I feel like you have to have certainty that he'd be interested in re-signing before making the trade. Because if you're Sam, you're just like, yeah, I'll go play wherever for a year and then just sign wherever the hell I want next year. So I think that is going to be a factor too. But again, I'd be fine getting Matthew Tkachuk for Samson. To Buffalo, 2022 first, 2023 first, Robin Salo and Kiefer Bellows. The Islanders coming in, I don't even think about them. I feel like you never hear the Islanders in, like, any Sabres trade rumors, which is funny. But again, you know those Islanders picks are going to be at the end of the first round. I'm thinking about, like, that 2023 first, and, like, so you're not drafting him for another 2 years, and then he's, like, a late first rounder, so he's probably going to take at least 3 years before he's NHL ready, like, minimum probably. So you're probably not seeing this guy. It's 2021 now. You're probably not seeing this guy until, like, if he actually develops until, like, 2026. Like, that's called patience. To Vegas, Sam Reinhart. To Buffalo, Alec Martinez and a second round pick. It's going to be hard for Buffalo to get much for a player that is not currently under contract for the 2022 season. This deal would see Buffalo gain negotiating rights to Alec Martinez in exchange for Vegas gaining negotiating rights to Reinhart. In fact, Reinhart is an RFA while Martinez is a UFA compensated by the second round pick. So Alec Martinez, there's no way, like, if he's a UFA, why would he sign with the Sabres? Like, unless the Sabres are giving him, like, a stupid amount of money. Like, that's the thing. Why would anyone want to sign with the Sabres right now? So that would be essentially Reinhart for a second. You know, the fact that Sam is an RFA means a team can have some control, and if he likes the team he's going to, which I'm sure he would love to play for Vegas, I don't see why he wouldn't sign long-term, or at least, you know, 3-4 years. It could be an issue. I just don't see that it would be that much of an issue, especially if, you know, the Sabres give permission to other teams to, like, talk to Reinhart or, like, gauge his interest. But yeah, there's no way UFA would sign with the Sabres. Sam Reinhart to Vegas for 2021 second, 2022 second, Keegan Kolsar, and signing rights to Matthias Janmark. Is this fair value? No, absolutely not, but unfortunately it seems Buffalo gets raked in a lot of trades, and Vegas always seems to get players for cheap. Stone, Leonard, and Martinez, all below market value. Yeah, so this is something that I've seen a lot, like, when I've been talking about, like, these players' trade value, and I'm not picking on you specifically, but it's just because I've seen it all the time that, like, people will send me trade offers that, you know, aren't what I think are considered good value, good return. And the person's response would be, well, it's because the Sabres always get raked in deals and the Sabres always get fleeced, and that's the best they're going to get because they don't have a general manager and they are dumb and they do these things. It's like, well, that's not really what I'm talking about. I'm just kind of, like, for the sake of discussion, like, saying, like, what do you think his value is at, not, you know, what the Sabres are going to trade for him. And the thing with Kevin Adams, too, is, like, I don't really think we fully know what he's capable of yet, and that's what's so exciting about this offseason, is that we're going to really see what he does and what he is capable of, what the best he can get, because there's, like... The Reinhart and Eichel trades would be hard for, like, an experienced GM. Like, the fact that he's such, like, an inexperienced general manager and he's forced to be making these trades in this kind of situation, he's putting himself, like, well, the Pegulas are putting him in a really tough position right now. But we really haven't been given much of a chance to see what he's capable of. He hasn't really made any horrible trades. Like, you can look at the Taylor Hall trade. But, I mean, he didn't have a lot of leverage there, Kevin Adams. He didn't want to lose Taylor Hall for nothing, so he just took whatever he can get. Could he have gotten more? Of course. But, you know, he got what he got and whatever. But other than that, there really isn't a ton of evidence to suggest that Kevin Adams is a bad general manager. We just haven't seen a lot from him yet. So I don't like this argument that, like, oh, the Sabres are going to get fleeced because they always do. Well, Kevin Adams really hasn't, other than the Taylor Hall trade, and that wasn't really... fleeced, it just wasn't great. Like, if you're talking about the O'Reilly trade, well, that wasn't Kevin Adams, that was Jason Botterill. Like, Jason Botterill made a ton of really awful trades. But, I mean, we gotta wait and see from Kevin Adams, so I don't really love the argument that, you know, the Sabres aren't gonna get a lot because they're bad at trades. Like, we literally just have to wait and see. Like, I'm not excited about the prospect of the Sabres losing my favorite players, because they don't want to be here. But if nothing else, it will be interesting to see how Kevin Adams does. I mean, this is his first real test as general manager, so we gotta see how it goes, and I'm honestly looking forward to it. So thank you to everyone who sent in trade offers. This was very interesting to do. I really like seeing what you guys think of these Sabres players. Make sure to hit that thumbs up button, as it really helps out my YouTube channel, and it's really quick and easy to do. As always, thank you for watching, guys. I will see you soon. Go Bills, go Sabres, go Blue Jays. Bye, guys.